So you probably know full well that you need to be creating highlights from your live stream and sharing those to social media. Or maybe you want to create full video guides about the game that it is you're playing so that you can share them on YouTube and try and gain an audience through YouTube as well. Well, you could of course just head to your Twitch VODs and download the full VOD from your stream, but that poses a couple of problems. Firstly, those downloaded VODs have some loss of quality just due to compression, because when you're streaming to Twitch, Twitch does all sorts of clever stuff to transcode your video, make sure that it can be served all across the world and to various different devices, computers, as well as mobile phones. So there is some small loss of quality. Secondly, and maybe more importantly, is if Twitch detects any kind of copyrighted music, it can mute the VOD, which means that when you head to download a highlight, maybe a sick play that you made on your stream that you remembered, you go to download the highlight and you find out that Twitch has muted the VOD, which can basically render the whole highlight useless. Well, that is what we are going to be solving in today's video. We're going to be looking at how you can set up your streaming software to stream and record at the same time, possibly even in different qualities if you wish to, so that you can have a really high quality format saved to your hard drive that you can then edit and share to social media. All coming up after a message from our sponsor. Nerd.ai's Borderline Stream Pack comes with everything you need to give your stream a clean and timeless look. Animated overlays, clean alerts, preloaded scenes, chat widgets, stingers, and so much more, all in a variety of different color schemes and customizations. To find out more and get 10% off at checkout, visit the link in the description. Before we dive into the settings on the computer, I will just say the caveat to this video is that you have already got your streaming settings set up properly. So if you have yet to even stream to Twitch, and you haven't set up any of your streaming settings, I would highly recommend checking out my video on how you can do all of that first. And if you're using an NVIDIA GTX 1060 or newer graphics card, and you aren't yet using the NVENC encoder, then also I would recommend checking out the video that I did when OBS and Streamlabs OBS implemented this new NVENC encoder into their streaming software, because you should be using that if you have the right graphics card. I'll leave both of them linked below and up in the top card if you need to pause this video and check out those first. But once you've got your streaming settings set up, we can dive into the recording settings. So the first thing that we need to decide what we're going to do is, are we going to be recording at the same quality that we're streaming at or at a higher quality? And there's advantages and disadvantages to both. The advantage of streaming at the same quality that we're recording at is that it is a much easier task for your computer to handle, since it's only taking each frame, encoding it once, and then sending that to the stream as well as sending it to the hard drive to record. Obviously, the main disadvantage is that you are basically having the same quality. You're limited by either Twitch's hard cap of 6,000 kilobits per second or the upload speed if it's lower than that. So you're not getting a really high quality video saved to your hard drive to share on social media. So the opposite to that, if you record at a higher quality than your stream, you obviously have the advantage of having a higher quality recording, which you can then edit, put together into highlights and upload to YouTube at a higher bit rate. But the disadvantage is that it's going to require more computational power, since you are technically encoding each frame of video twice, once for the stream at a certain quality that you're sending to Twitch, and then once at a higher quality that you're sending to your hard drive to record. So once you've decided which of those two methods it is that you want to do, let's head over to the streaming PC and get set up. Okay, so here we are in OBS, and if you're a Streamlabs OBS user, the process is exactly the same. This is part of the core OBS functionality that Streamlabs originally ported over. So all you need to do is open up settings, the names of the tabs and the names of the settings, and the information that you plug into each setting is exactly the same, no matter if you're using OBS or Streamlabs OBS. So head down to the output tab, and if you're wanting to record and stream at the same quality, the process is really, really simple. You want the output mode here to be set to simple. Your streaming settings should already be set up, as I explained at the start of the video. And then you want to come down to recording quality and just change this to same as stream. And that's going to mean that it uses the same bit rate as you have set for your stream output up here. So it's going to use the same encoder and the same bit rate. There are just a couple of other settings that I would recommend changing here. The recording path, I would recommend setting this to a hard drive that is different to the hard drive where your games are running from. The reason for that is because when your game is running and you're playing a game, there are lots of things that your computer is loading from the installation where you installed the game originally. Things like map textures or models are going to be loaded from this hard drive. So if you are asking your streaming software to also record video to the same hard drive, hard drive is technically trying to read and write quite quickly from the same drive. So just to avoid any issues, I would recommend if you do have a second hard drive, record to the second hard drive somewhere where the games aren't installed, and it should prevent any kinds of issues with read and write speeds. The other thing I recommend changing is the recording format. It's really tempting to use MP4 because that works with all of your video editing software. It's really easy to upload to different social medias, but it is worth changing out of MP4 for one reason that is highlighted here in yellow. Basically, if you use MP4 and there is some kind of issue, maybe you have a power cut or your streaming software crashes, you will lose all of the recording up to that point. Whereas if you use a recording format such as MKV, not only do you get multiple audio tracks if you wish to use them, but you also don't have that issue. If you have a blue screen or a power cut or something like that, your recording is not lost. You can recover all of the data that you recorded up to that point. It does mean that there's an extra step after you finish recording. You will need to come up to the file menu and go to Remux Recordings, and here you can add in the MKV file and it will output an MP4 that you can then use in all of your editing software. But it's worth just doing that extra step for all the extra reliability that you get in terms of a recording breaking. Now, if you are wanting to record at a different quality to your stream settings, that is gonna need you to come up to output mode and change from simple to advanced. Again, your streaming settings should already be set up. As I said at the start of the video, if you come across to the recording tab, there are a few settings that we need to change here. Again, I would just suggest changing the recording path and the recording format, as I just mentioned, to MKV and to a hard drive that is separate to the one that your game runs from. You can select multiple audio tracks if you're using the MKV video format, but that's probably a topic for a separate video. And then you want to be using the same encoder that you are using for your streaming. So if you are using a newer NVIDIA card, the 1060 or newer, as I've explained in previous videos, I recommend using the new NVENC encoder that's built into OBS and Streamlabs OBS. So I would use that for both streaming and recording. Technically, your encoder is going to be encoding two separate bit rates, one for the stream and one for your hard drive. But if you keep using the same encoder, at least it isn't having to transfer those frames from your GPU to your CPU or vice versa. So set your encoder here and then come down to the rate control. If you are using NVENC, I recommend changing the rate control to CQP. And then the CQ level, this is basically the quality level that your recording is recording at. So a lower number is a higher quality recording, but also a much larger file size. So if you want something that is perceivably lossless, you can set this to a CQ level of 14. But if you are going to be recording a whole 5+ hour stream, that is going to eat through your hard drive space quite quickly. So I would recommend if you're recording a whole stream, maybe setting this to a level between 18 and 22. Again, a lower number is a higher quality, but also a larger file size. The rest of the settings can be left to what they were for your stream. So keyframe interval, that should be at 2. Your preset can be quality or max quality, just depending on if you're running into any performance issues, you might want to drop this back down to quality. Profile to high, look ahead unchecked, psychovisual tuning checked, leave the GPU at 0 and max B frames at 2. If, however, you are using X264 for your encoding, maybe you don't have one of the newer GPUs from NVIDIA, I would recommend setting the rate control to CRF. And that is a similar sort of quality level where a lower number is a higher quality. And again, if you want to set a lossless, a perceivably lossless recording, set this to 14, but a number between 18 and 22 is going to be better for longer streams. So I'll set this to 20 also. Exact same as before, keyframe interval should be set to 2. The CPU usage preset, since you're recording at such a higher bit rate here compared to your stream, there's actually not really much use in dropping this down to a slower preset because it's just going to increase the CPU usage. So you can leave this at very fast or even go to super fast if you wish to, because you're recording at a much higher bit rate. You're not restricted by the Twitch bandwidth options. So you can leave this at very fast. Profile, you can set it to high if you wish to, and then leave everything else as it is. A couple of little bonus tips that I would like to suggest. The amount of times that I've started streaming by clicking the start streaming button and forgotten to also click start recording. OBS has implemented a feature to prevent you forgetting that. If you come back into settings and go to the general tab, you'll see this option here to automatically record when streaming. And that just means as soon as you click start streaming, start recording will also be automatically checked and the recording will start to your hard drive. The second option that I would just recommend you using is if you head down to the advanced tabs, you should see that you have this in the recording option. You should have automatically remix to MP4. If you have chosen to use the MKV video format, like I've suggested, to prevent those issues with reliability, if you ever have a blue screen or a streaming software crash, this option just automatically remixes that MKV to MP4 as soon as the recording completes. So you don't need to go up into the option file remix recordings. It will just do it automatically and save in the same folder that your recording was originally saved in. Hopefully this has been a helpful video for you guys and you have now got set up with streaming while simultaneously recording in your streaming software. If it has been useful, please do give the video a thumbs up. And if you're new around here, highly recommend checking out the rest of the content we have on the channel and subscribing if you haven't already. A massive thanks as always to the Gaming Careers patrons who help support this channel. I couldn't do what I do without you guys. And if you aren't yet a member of the Gaming Careers Discord, I would highly recommend checking out. There is a link in the description. Loads of people helping each other there. And this video topic actually was a suggestion from that Discord. So click the link to join the Gaming Careers Discord as well. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.